Hi, I'm Hansi Herzog. Welcome to Co-Create. Our vision is to unite the world community so we're able to co-create a good life for all. Therefore, we invite you to become part of the world's largest co-creation partnership. So to explain more about what this means and to get in contact with you, our community, we decided to start the 30 days video challenge. So welcome on day 27. Today is Wednesday. I just arrived 1 hour ago in Vienna. I was flying from Chile to Vienna, to my home. Moved into my new old home, took a shower, and now I'm back to the laptop again to bring you this video. Today is actually co-create in action. Yesterday, co-create explained. But because of the old situation, it's a little bit mixed through. So for today, we have a presentation for you. So that's the reason why I'm on the laptop. I will share my screen. Yes. And we are there perfectly. So put myself up here. Not so important for now. So in last videos, we were speaking already about the gamification approach of the platform. And we made a presentation to have a specific look on this case. And I would like to share this presentation with you, slide for slide, presenting for you. And yeah, getting another feeling of how Co-Create is feeling and doing. Please keep in mind, this presentation is not focusing on the gamification approach. It's not representing all aspects of Co-Create, but looks from one point of view of Co-Create. And yeah, let's start into it. Just make this run. Here we go. So, World of Co-Creation is the idea of the gamified invitation to the world's largest co-creation partnership. It's about, it's an invitation to co-create together the sustainable reality we would like to have. And most of you know sustainability has three dimensions. It's the social, the ecological and the environment part. And yeah, World of Co-Creation is so for the gamification approach of Co-Create. So it can be said it's the first massive multiplayer online plus offline game for positive change makers. So MMO or MMORPG is well known in the computer scene for big worlds of people interacting online together, and we use this picture. And you see here also we're referring to Linux, Wikipedia, and Minecraft, because all of them have this special approach that the community is coming together to create something together and to share. And this is the mindset we really want to go with. Especially Linux goes there very, very deep, because Linux, if you don't know, it's an operating system like Windows or the one from Apple, but it's totally open source, so it is developed through the community as well as the programs running on it, and it's all open source. And so Wikipedia and Minecraft give an environment. Linux is going there even further and also creating this environment together, and that's something we attending to. But let's looking more, and what's really important here, it's really the world is constantly expanding with our actions. So we as community, we bring step by step, stone by stone, all this ecosystem together. So what we do is accelerating sustainable developing by providing freer approaches. So it starts with the ecosystem framework, the operating system, the model we have created. On top of that, we have built this online and offline facilitation methodology or approach, where you and the community are guided step by step through a process how you can grow strong ecosystems. And on top of that, we plan to develop this gamified online platform. Means it is an online platform in a gamified way. Gamification, this let's have a look, what does it mean? Gamification is approach how you can do a lot of games, why games are so activating and so empowering. And it's mainly about having a clear goal clear feeling of progression, so a good feedback system. And we want to use gamification as an approach which makes it easier for you to step into the co-creation and are involved in this global collaboration process. And these three approaches actually takes place on the global and local level. So the keyword there is global, one modern word. And on this global and local level, we aim to grow strong ecosystems, which might result in your reach in a community cooperative. So we suggest to use cooperative as legal mind friend to do this. It's not, it's not like a rule, but it's a very strong suggestion. And all of these local community cooperatives are then connecting this global solution ecosystem we are speaking of. And yeah, let's go for that. So we're turning problems into solutions. So we divide it in three different levels. It starts really with missing capacities for transformative collaboration. So changemakers maybe want to collaborate, but the lack of time, of resources, of skills, of tools maybe. And because it is so, we lose to build strong connections and get easy access. So right now, everything you want to do, each step for sustainability, to start the project or to buy locally or regionally, costs a lot of effort. It's set by transaction costs. So the transaction costs are very high. And at the end, it leads that we still have many interdependent problems, challenges. And we refer here to the 17 SDGs. It's one framework beside others, but it's very well known. And yeah, we solve this by co-creating a self-organized changemaker infrastructure. So this changemaker infrastructure should help you to have easy access to everything you need. And we do this through collecting, structuring, and disseminating, so spreading out resources, knowledge, and contacts, products, and so on. And everything is there to enable an easy solution implementation on a global scale. So if you have easy access to already existing knowledge, to the partners you find, you need, and the resources you need to do so, it's much more easier for you to implement solutions, and therefore on another side, for other people to use those products you produce or the services you bring. And this way we grow together this strong ecosystem by everybody's showing up and just bringing in what he needs. Then we see suddenly that we already have everything we need. It's just a question about the connection. So the value proposal is that together we can make change easy. So we accelerate individual and collective impact. Very important. You for your organization individually, but together. And we have a look on four major target groups, which can come out of all sectors of society. This is always very important for us. And yeah, we have the service provider, but in the ecosystem model, we call it the infrastructure. So they have the benefit of getting better market conditions and can create together better products by turning competition into collaboration. And they provide services like IT tools, funding, communication, facilitation to changemakers. These changemakers can be, of course, other service providers as well. Can also be private person, but most of the time there are changemakers working on specific topics. So in the ecosystem model, the one thing you saw before is a topic level where we relate to the SDGs. And those topic changemakers work now on very specific things like gender equality, healthcare system, providing sustainable food or electricity, and they need this easy access to the resources so they can create their solutions for. This is what we call the public sphere, where the private persons are and want to have easy access to the everyday goods and products they need. So it's food, electricity, healthcare, and so on and so on. And of course, also topic change makers and service providers on the private level are part of this sphere of private person. And at the end, of course, a lot of private persons at one space make together the municipality or community. And by implementing these local solutions on a local level, we can increase the common good through the community cooperatives. So that's our logic of thinking, how we can support this. And of course, it's a closing circle. So let's move on. The USP is here really, Co-create is a holistic multi-stakeholder approach. For us, it's very important. In the center, you see the ecosystem model again, and we have the four different sectors, on the global and local, as well online and offline scale. So we have this approach based on the scientific model, and it is delivered through a gamification environment. This is something very, very special if you compare to other platforms or ecosystems out there. So for the gamification approach, we were thinking about the changemaker hero's journey. So what is the experience of a changemaker? And probably you have experienced something else, something similar by yourself, something other as well possible. So everything starts with the village, so the environment where a person is, and there is a challenge. And somebody has to hear this challenge and following the call. So it's the becoming of the changemaker. And in the hero's journey, it's a storytelling format. They always speak about a first failure after the first start. So there's the first failure. I don't know what's your experience. I've been changemaker for over 10 years and often realized I want to do something and I start and blah, 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 and don't get to the point really. So then there's the phase of the homecoming, the refraction back to the struggling city, village. And actually what we want to aim to is to forming team of heroes. So a changemaker hero alone cannot bring change. Therefore it's important to get together. And in this case is getting together and prepare yourself for the next try to achieve a goal. And in our case, it's about building this infrastructure. So if you want to try as a change maker to reach a goal, but you struggling and need so much energy to get all the resources and infrastructure and things you need, and you have a lack of resources and tools, you probably will fail again. So we set a very high focus on this infrastructure building. And then when it's successfully, you have a strong infrastructure, you have a team, then the success can really come. Don't forget to celebrate. And if you come home, your village, and this is an outlook at the gamification approach, where we'll include a village where you can develop and have some rewards and to give a little bit more playful touch where you can also collect. Because this is this hero journey is on the one side now landed on the storytelling aspect of the hero journey, but otherwise we really want to build this into the gamification approach for you to make it exciting to go on journeys with groups and resolve problems together. So how does it work? The idea is together we can shape each part of our reality, but how we do this? So at the beginning, there's always an invitation. Therefore, we say co-create is the invitation to the world's largest co-creation partnership. So it's all about you making the first step. And on the first level, we want to provide this gamified co-creation environment with some things making it more easy for you and playful to join. And then immediately the co-creation is beginning. So it's about bringing together different communities to one community of communities, and with methodologies like crowdsourcing, co-creation challenging, and community votings, we want to develop what is important for you as changemaker. And this developing takes place by bringing together already existing solutions. That's the main key for co-create. Because we don't want to develop a new platform and be a competitor to other platforms. We want to make these gaps that different similar platforms can come together, share the resources, share the knowledge, and build something better together. because otherwise there are competitors, we lose energy, and we might not get the best products we need as changemakers to really make a deep transformation. So we can connect marketplace, library, a project forge where you can start your own project. We can include a cryptocurrency, educational mini games. There are so many things out there which already exist. It's really about bringing them together at one stop, one point. And then when we have a very very nice global level online platform where everybody can easily access the resources and share, it's very important to focus again on the local level. So therefore we have our approach, our development approach, step-by-step guidance, where you have the possibility also in a hero's journey gamified to grow your own local ecosystem, where you can exchange knowledge within your ecosystem, but also connect to resources and knowledge around the world. And at the end, it's something we call the open co-creation. It's when we have this strong ecosystem on a global and local level, it's easy then to co-create everything you want. So this reflecting to the each part of society, because we have solutions to really all topics of society. And then we can go in the open co-creation. We call this open co-creation because it's then about your projects and your topics before we focusing more on the infrastructure and very necessities. Because that's also another difference in the co-create approach is the strategic approach. There are already collaboration platforms where you as organization or person or community can upload challenges for other groups. But you will always come to this point, even if you've created the best solution, by implementing of the solution, you need again the resources and everything the infrastructure can provide. So we're focusing on this first so we can later scale up the solution implementation. I think that's one very, very core experience why Co-Create has been developed like this. So it's really like a spiral starting this invitation. Grow by connecting different parts of the ecosystem which already exist, and then we can co-create each part of society all around the world because we relate to each other in our actions, in our efforts, in our tools and resources. That might be a small side effect, but for some people probably still important is that we can play with different visual skins. So we see on the left side the classic text base and the modern hero's journey. That's something we imagine for the start. Classic text based means that there is like an online platform with less gamification for those people who don't want to be forced to gamify. And then we have as the simple basic, the modern hero's journey as first approach for gamify your experience on this platform. And then together as community, we can create different skins which we would like to see, like the fantasy focus, or anime, or science fiction. It's then all about storytelling, visualization, and then we can be flexible and joyful in a way it makes easy sense for you to interact with this platform. So the roadmap, actually we'll see how this will change through the Corona situation. And I will not read everything here. The main thing with these different colors is that we want to develop in different circles. So the pre-alpha version is right now, we're developing the pre-alpha to start the alpha version soon, where we can already connect some first tools and where we can use this experience to actually develop a beta version. A beta version would be like a gamified browser platform, so it's really a platform in your browser like standard platforms, and it's gamified. And on this first experience we can build on, then with developing a version 1.0, which might already include a mobile app, and it should come also a board game. So to have this ecosystem building experience without digital aspects, but just offline for you, you can play with a group on your table. And the far future, and maybe I'll make a video about this as well, it's really a full integrated AAA, means high quality production of this massive multiplayer online world. And there are it's very futuristic what we can have here, but I'm looking forward to speak another time about that, what can happen if you connect our AR or VR with a full ecosystem. Yeah, some funny things where I want to go in detail now. On the right side, you also see the planning of EU and world tour. So what I really want to do is to travel and to go to different projects and places. But again, it's cool. We'll see how this turns out. The possibility for me to become a nomadic change maker. I have spoken about this in yesterday's video. So financial needs, all these numbers are very rough, but in overall we can say they have been around 150,000 euro already invested in this project in the past. And to make the next steps, we search for around 245. Might be possible to make it cheaper and easier, but we really want to make it as good as possible. So we really want to take money in our hands. And of course, the bigger development is 10,000 euros in money. We always go for different streams. So right now we started our online platform and private loan searching, and we will reach out for philanthropies, foundations and grants as well. And a little bit later, we'll start a crowdfunding campaign when we are able to share more with you. Market numbers, it's because there were so often the question about numbers. You can study this in detail. It was just to have a look where we can reflect to, relate to, and get some numbers from. Cultural creatives is our specific scene in the changemaker. We have the game-based learning market, mobile gaming, and they compared us to Wikipedia and Linux and Minecraft, what they do, what how much interaction they had in the past to figure out some numbers. Yeah. So when we imagine that we could have just 0.001 of the total market of the mobile and the mobile gaming and game-based learning, we can already get to very nice numbers. And as well, if we take 1% of similar products, would show that would be a greater success already. And we hope we can go to there. And we can make it possible together by connecting our communities, because we are so many already, like the cultural creators are showing us. So I really can recommend this study to deep dive more into it. Yeah, but let's continue. Revenue streams, very important. We want to collect money from different streams, so to be as much independent as possible. And we call it like a freemium platform cooperative social business model. Haha. So it's a social business model. Yeah, we do business to have enough resources in the organization, but it's social orientated. So it's not about profit. So neither I nor there will be no other shareholders getting any profit out of it. Therefore, we choose a cooperative as legal structure, and platform cooperatives, the platform co-ops, is a new movement coming up where more and more platform services are organized through cooperatives instead of big companies. So we have alternatives to Uber and Amazon and so on already. And freemium is regarding to the platform. So there will be some stuff for free and some for paying if you want to use it. And you see the other streams around here. Very important for the deep logic of the ecosystem is, you see in the right corner, the money is collected in the fund, and from there it will be invested in the different community cooperatives bringing the service. So they have a great platform. We connect existing platforms, support them to grow a community cooperative, and they get money from the funds to develop the products. It's the same with facilitation, communication, and so on. And after a while, they can, when they are able, they can pay it back and stay connected with a solidarity fee. And through this, this fund can grow in itself. Through the more active the community is getting, the bigger it grows, and can then also invest in specific topic organizations after the infrastructure is built. So global team, let's have a look. There are so many people we have had the luck in the past to work together. Some of them we still work together on similar single projects or smaller tasks. It's mean me as founder and chief visionary officer now, making the next step to next phase. We will then search a CTO to develop the platform. And we have also other partners and supporters like Green TI, where we wanted to start the discovery process. Now, because of Corona, it's a little bit about break, but on break, but we can continue this. Christian Lepelé does the prototype in Chile right now, and we want to get in contact regarding a crowdfunding campaign. And at the end, it's really to say there are much more people I should or I have to mention. So we built this now in presentation because we are just standing on the shoulders of giants. There have been so much before. I'm trying to not invent the wheel from the beginning, but build on things which already exist and connect them. And therefore, we hope to create a holistic approach. We're really happy about people who give influence, give feedback, help to develop this. And yeah, so by watching and giving feedback and comments, you are also part of this big group. Thank you a lot. Yeah, to reassume this, our vision is to unite the world community to co-create a good life for all. Because, and this is a picture of this spaceship Earth, we just have this planet, this chance, and we really have to learn how to relate to each other and develop a small community. That's the end of the presentation. It took already some time. It's the first run. We'll keep it like that. You will see we are also preparing right now the pre-alpha that you have the possibility to get some tries. This link doesn't work now. But yeah, this is it. We had the presentation. Was a try, like we said, in the 30 days challenge, we want to try different formats. We hope you enjoyed very much detail. For today, I just say thank you for watching. If you liked it, if you have any questions, thoughts, or ideas, please leave it as a comment below. Leave us also a thumb up if you like the video and hit the bell to subscribe to our channel. Today is tomorrow is Thursday. Thursday is collaboration knowledge, and I'm wishing you a great day. See you. Bye.